Good morning. So in this video I am going to discuss about Claisen-Smith condensation reaction and its mechanism of Claisen-Smith condensation reaction as well as mechanism. Okay, right. First let us understand what is Claisen-Smith condensation. This is simply also called as Claisen reaction. Okay, right. Now here in Claisen-Smith reaction, benzaldehyde, an aromatic aldehyde, reacts with an aliphatic aldehyde. So this is a reaction between an aromatic aldehyde, benzaldehyde, and an aliphatic aldehyde, okay, or aliphatic ketone, either aliphatic aldehyde or aliphatic ketone in presence of a base, dilute NaOH, forming either alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde, either alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde or alpha beta unsaturated ketone is what we call it as Claisen-Smith condensation reaction. Okay, but basically it is reaction between an aromatic aldehyde and aliphatic aldehyde, or an aromatic aldehyde and aliphatic ketone. If an aromatic aldehyde and aliphatic aldehyde reacts, the product is nothing but alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. If an aromatic aldehyde like benzaldehyde reacts with an aliphatic ketone, then the product is nothing but alpha beta unsaturated ketone. Okay, benzaldehyde reacts with aldehyde or ketone, giving an unsaturated aldehyde or ketone is generally called as Claisen-Smith reaction. This reaction occurs in presence of dilute NaOH. Okay, so I have written an equation format: when benzaldehyde reacts with an aliphatic aldehyde in presence of NaOH, giving alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde is Claisen reaction, or an aromatic aldehyde benzaldehyde reacts with the aliphatic ketone. You can use either aldehyde or ketone. Okay, right. Giving alpha beta unsaturated ketone. Okay, with benzaldehyde, if you have aldehyde, you'll get a unsaturated aldehyde as a product. With benzaldehyde, if you use aliphatic ketone, the product will be unsaturated ketone. Okay, right. Now we have given example for both. So CH5CHO is nothing but benzaldehyde, isn't it? An aromatic aldehyde. What is called? Benzaldehyde. This reacts with an aliphatic aldehyde, CH3CHO. Acetaldehyde, or otherwise ethanol, an aldehyde with two carbon derivative ethanol in presence of dilute base, dilute NaOH, giving an alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde. So these two reactants will give this one as a product, isn't it? CH5 single bond CH, double bond CH, single bond CHO, which is called as cinnamaldehyde. Name of this product is what? Cinnamaldehyde. An aromatic unsaturated aldehyde. Cinnamaldehyde is an example for aromatic. It has a phenyl group, so aromatic. There is a double bond unsaturated aldehyde group, so aromatic unsaturated aldehyde. Okay, right. If suppose benzaldehyde reacts with an aliphatic ketone, what you called as acetone, CH3CO, CH3 compound is nothing but acetone. Acetone or a three carbon ketone, propanone. Okay, right. In presence of base, dilute base, you are getting a alpha beta unsaturated ketone of this formula, isn't it? Which is called as benzyl acetone. Name of this ketone is nothing but benzyl acetone, alpha beta unsaturated ketone. Okay, right. It's a product formed from benzaldehyde and acetone, so it is called as benzyl acetone. Okay, right. Now, so we have discussed the example for Claisen-Smith reaction. Now let us discuss the mechanism of Claisen-Smith reaction. Okay, right. Now I am going to discuss the mechanism of reaction between an aromatic aldehyde and aliphatic aldehyde. Okay, now the first step is nothing but formation of a carbanion. Okay, now here what is happening is the aliphatic aldehyde CH3CHO, which is nothing but acetaldehyde or ethanol, isn't it? It forms a carbanion, in presence of base. That base produces OH minus ion. That OH minus ion will take up the alpha hydrogen as a proton. That H plus is added with this OH minus and becomes as H2O. So that by the time that bond pair will be retained by this carbon. Bond pair is retained by this carbon. So the carbon gets a negative charge. So carbanion. You get a carbanion of formula CH2 minus CH. Okay. That's the first step. Removal of alpha hydrogen as proton by the base and forming a carbanion. Okay. Right. Now the carbanion of aliphatic aldehyde will react with the aromatic aldehyde. Okay, there is a second step. Here the carbanion is acting as a nucleophile. This carbanion acts as nucleophile negatively charged, so electron rich, so it acts as a nucleophile, so that it attacks carbonyl carbon of benzaldehyde, because carbonyl carbon of benzaldehyde is electron deficient center, so that electron rich carbanion attacks electron deficient carbon center. Okay, by the time the bond pair between carbon oxygen will move to oxygen, so it becomes single bond O minus. Okay, so you get this product. Now carbanion carbon forms a new bond with carbonyl carbon, and double bond O will become single bond O minus. Okay, you get a species with a negative charge, so we call it as anion. Okay, the second step after the nucleophilic attack by the carbanion of aliphatic aldehyde, we get a product of anion. Okay, right, so next step, the anion is getting protonated, followed by it undergoes dehydration. Okay, third step is nothing but protonation and dehydration. Okay, now this is the anion which is formed in the previous step, second step, isn't it? Now this anion is getting protonated by water, which is formed in the first step. Okay, that O minus will attack H plus, becomes OH, H plus O minus OH. Now bond pair is retained by oxygen, so it becomes OH minus byproduct. Okay, right, now this anion is getting protonated. Okay, O minus becomes OH, isn't it? So that you are getting a beta hydroxy aldehyde. Actually, what is this one? Beta hydroxy, see this function group, alpha carbon, beta carbon, beta carbon, there is a hydroxy group, isn't it? So beta hydroxy aldehyde, isn't it? Right, now this beta hydroxy aldehyde undergoes dehydration. This step is nothing but dehydration step. This compound on heating may lose water molecule, that is hydrogen from alpha carbon, OH group from beta carbon will be removed as water minus H2O, isn't it? So that a new bond is formed over here, so that it becomes CH double bond CH. So the product is CCCH5 single bond CH double bond CH single bond CH. Okay, and alpha beta unsaturated aldehyde, which is called as cinnamaldehyde. What is it called? Cinnamaldehyde. Okay, right, previous video I think we have discussed about Perkin's reaction, whereas in Perkin's reaction, in the place of CHO we have COH group, there we called it as cinnamic acid, isn't it? Here you have aldehyde group, CHO group, so it is called as cinnamaldehyde. Okay, right, this is what about the mechanism of Claisen-Smith reaction. Okay, I hope you understood about the mechanism of Claisen reaction. Okay, thank you, and keep watching all my videos. Thank you very much.